This is the part of the show where we sample a food or drink and review it right on the spot.
Now today, we saw this on Instagram at some point. Somebody took a picture of Dr. Pepper, thank you Lisa, Dr. Pepper barbecue sauce.
And I even got a text from you about 2 hours ago, a picture of Dr. Pepper barbecue sauce that says, we have to try this, right?
Yeah, I mean, Dr. Pepper and A&W.
Yeah.
And I mean, okay.
It's the worst kind of cross-promotion branding.
Absolutely.
It's like, you know, when TGI Fridays does, like, Captain Crunch, like, fish sticks or whatever.
Right, right,
and you're
right,
like,
right.
Come on,
right,
guys.
Yeah, right, right.
No. It's
yeah.
exactly what this is.
Exactly.
But I will be the first. Thank you, Lisa, so much.
Thanks, Lisa.
The first to admit that I was intrigued as shit. So let's take a look at these bottles. These are, this is just...
We got here.
Who makes this barbecue sauce?
Well, first, I looked at this company, Vita Specialty Foods Incorporated.
Right.
So
Vita?
not your top notch brand necessarily, but you know, it could be something. You never know.
Would you?
Now the A&W is considered rich and hearty.
Oh, whereas the Dr. Pepper is sweet and kicking.
Mm. Oh, so you know, there's going to be a big difference between these. We've grilled up a couple sausages
here. Yeah, so what kind of sausage are we eating here?
Lisa, what are these sausages, actually? They are from
Trader Joe's.
Like Trader Joe's sausages.
I'm going for the A&W first.
Okay. I will hit the Dr. Pepper.
Okay, I'm going for A&W as well. It does taste pretty root beery.
I mean, as barbecue sauces go, it's a sweet one.
Uh-huh.
Kansas City sauces tend to be sweet, so this is actually a little bit familiar. Mm. You know, it kind of tastes like a little like Sweet Baby Ray's.
I love Sweet Baby Ray's.
Not to compare it too much, because Sweet Baby Ray's is actually kind of good for like a sweet barbecue sauce. And
okay.
This really isn't great, but it's way better than I thought it was going to be.
It's actually much better than I thought it was going to be.
Dr. Pepper's not bad. Has a little bit, I mean, the sausage has a little kick to it, right? Jalapeno cheddar sausage.
Oh, jalapeno.
So it's not just a bratwurst. Jalapeno cheddar.
Jalapeno. All right, I'm going to try the Dr. Pepper.
Okay, I just tried the Dr. Pepper, and it does taste like Dr. Pepper.
Mm-hmm.
Wow. That must have 23 ingredients in there.
At least. I don't know. Get good barbecue sauce, right? It's interesting, though.
It is much better than I thought it was going to be.
Yeah, I thought it was going to suck shit.
Yeah, me too.
Decent barbecue sauce.
It's actually decent barbecue sauce.
It's really molasses-y. It's super sugary
and
sweet.
It's like your Casey masterpiece. Like the stuff you buy in the store. It's not...
Yeah, right.
It's not your Gates.
No, it's not a Gates. I mean, it's not a Bryant's.
Yeah,
not a Bryant's.
To be barbecue snobs for just a minute here.
Yeah.
Yeah, like... We've had some really good barbecue sauce before. This is totally fine. Definitely better than I thought it was going to be.
Yeah.
I thought it was just a gimmick. You can kind of taste it in there. I don't know what it would be like on a whole meal. We're just dipping a little sausage in there.
You know, that's the problem with taste tests.
By the way.
It is spicy. That's the problem with taste tests, though, is that if you do one bite,
yeah,
people tend to prefer sweeter stuff, I think. I think that's what I've read, which is why, like, Pepsi always wins taste tests, and why sweet barbecue sauces always win taste tests over spicy or smoky ones. But if you're going to eat an entire rack of ribs covered with this stuff, you don't want to go into a diabetic coma because of the barbecue sauce.
Right, it's
you
one
know?
Of those things where, a little taste is like the right amount.
Yeah.
And if you have a whole chicken covered in this thing, then eventually you're like, oh, God, I can't.
So I suppose
this.
The recommendation is if you have a jalapeno cheese sausage piece on a toothpick or skewer.
Right.
It's amazing.
Dr. Pepper or A&W, recommended. Otherwise, probably go with
something better.
And speaking of something better, might as well go to barbecues galore. Or on Pico, roughly at Veteran, I think.
Mm-hmm.
It's in West LA. It's kind of near the Palms-ish area.
Yeah, I've seen that place.
It's right next door to Norm's. They carry an incredible selection of barbecue sauces.
Do they really?
They have Arthur Bryant's.
They do?
They have a couple different kinds of Arthur Bryant's, and they carry all of Gates styles.
That's
so
cool.
They're totally overpriced.
Kansas City barbecue fans, obviously.
Yeah. So if you're not into KC barbecue, you might be a little disappointed.
Do they have like North Carolina styles? Have they got the whole range?
I don't know if they have like mustard and vinegar style sauces. Okay. I would hope they would, because a lot are represented that specifically. I'm not positive.
Mm-hmm. Right.
But if you're looking for some overpriced sauces that you probably can't like get in person anywhere else that I'm aware of,
right?
Barbecues Galore and Pico is probably good. Now,
all right.
By all means, you can get this shit mail order. But Last Minute Barbecue, want to impress your friends with your knowledge of Kansas City barbecue sauce, that's where to go.
Pretty awesome.
We should find a way to put a link up on our site or something.
Or maybe like right here.
Yeah, or like right here. Oh, my God. Okay. I think that leads us right into a brand new segment.